Rejoice we all in the Lord, keeping holy day in honor of all the saints, in whose solemnity the angels rejoice and glorify the Son of God. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ saith. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
The Lord be with you.
And
let us pray. O Almighty God, who has knit together thine elect in one communion and fellowship in the mystical body of thy Son, Christ our Lord, grant us grace so to follow thy blessed saints in all virtuous and godly living, that we may come to those unspeakable joys which thou hast prepared for those who unfeignedly love thee, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord, who with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost art one God, world without end. Portion of scripture appointed to be read for the epistle is found in the seventh chapter of the Revelation of St. John the Divine, beginning at the second verse. In those days, behold, I, John, was in the Spirit, and I saw another angel ascending from the east, having the seal of the living God. And he cried with a loud voice to the four angels to whom it was given to hurt the earth and the sea, saying, "Hurt not the earth, neither the sea, nor the trees, till we have sealed the servants of our God in their foreheads." And I heard the number of them which were sealed, and there were sealed 144,000 of all the tribes of the children of Israel. After this I beheld, and lo, a great multitude, which no man could number, of all nations and kindreds and peoples and tongues, stood before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed with white robes and palms in their hands, and cried with a loud voice, saying, Salvation to our God, which sitteth upon the throne and unto the Lamb. And all the angels stood round about the throne and about the elders and the four living creatures, and fell before the thrones on their faces, and worshiped God, saying, Amen. Blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be unto our God forever and ever. Amen. And one of the elders answered, saying unto me, What are these which are arrayed in white robes, and whence came they? And I said unto him, Sir, thou knowest. And he said unto me, These are they which came out of great tribulation and have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Therefore are they before the throne of God and serve him day and night in his temple. And he that sitteth on the throne shall dwell among them. They shall hunger no more, neither thirst any more, neither shall the sun light on them, nor any heat. For the Lamb which is in the midst of the throne shall feed them, and shall lead them unto living fountains of water. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes. Here endeth the epistle. The Lord be with you. The Holy Gospel is written in the fifth chapter of the Gospel according to St. Matthew, beginning at the first verse.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
Jesus, seeing the multitudes, went up into a mountain. And when he was set, his disciples came up unto him, and he opened his mouth and taught them, saying, Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. Blessed are they which are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are ye when men shall revile you and persecute you, and shall say all manner of evil against you falsely for my sake. Rejoice and be exceeding glad, for great is your reward in heaven. For so persecuted they the prophets which were before you. Praise be to thee, O Christ. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary and was made man and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried. And the third day he rose again, according to the scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord and giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Today you're going to hear something from the preface of the church, which is in the midst of the Mass, right before we begin the canon of the Mass. And we will say, the preface says, for All Saints' Day, which this is what we're celebrating. The preface says, God has compassed us about with so great a cloud of witnesses that we can run the race with patience that is set before us, and together with them receive the crown of glory which fadeth not away. So the question is, and perhaps you really don't know much about it, what is this cloud of witnesses that we pray and thank God for this day? Well, it's the communion of saints. It's an essential belief of the church, and it's taught through the ages. It's part of the Apostles' Creed, not the Nicene Creed, but the Apostles' Creed, which we say systematically for morning and evening prayer. It is the binding together of the faithful on earth with the souls of those who have died and gone before us, together with the saints who are already this day in the presence of God in heaven. You see, and you've heard this before, and you'll hear it time and again, hopefully, because you'll be in a church that preaches and proclaims the gospel and teaches it also. God's church is bigger than the sum of its parts. What we see with the eye is only one part of the church. There are essentially three rooms in the household of faith. The first one is the church militant. That's you and me. You know, essentially there are two parts in the faith, the quick and the dead. The quick, that means we're alive. And some of us are quicker than others. But we are alive, and so we are part of the church militant. Now, some people are hesitant in our, I'm going to call it a flaccid age that we live in, that they talk and they think that such militant terms are not at all a good idea. It's too militaristic, they say, saying that such talk is offensive to the modern ear. Well, I will tell you that that is pure, unadulterated poppycock. It's not true. You and I are fighting in the faith, fighting the good fight, as St. Paul puts it. And so here we are. That's why we call these people, we who are alive, that's why we call it the church militant. But there's more to whom God's love and grace and presence is given, and more to whom we are in mystical sweet communion. The second portion, the second room in the household of God is the church expectant. That's the folk who have died and gone before us. Now, we pray for those, and normally we remember those family and friends who have died and gone before us. We pray for them systematically, and sometimes they are in our minds every other day or every day. And yet we also pray at every single Mass that we celebrate here in this church and in God's Church Universal. We pray at that Mass in the prayer for the whole state of Christ Church, and you'll hear it, that we ask God to grant them continual growth in thy love and service. And then we tie those who have died and gone before us, we tie ourselves to them when we say, give us grace to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Isn't that just powerful? The church militant, you and me, praying for the church expectant. And it ought to be that way, and it is. Now, we used to call this part of the church purgatory. But you can call it whatever you want. We believe, the church teaches, that it exists, even though we don't know all that much about it. Church militant, church expectant, number three, church triumphant. They are those who are this day in God's presence and who have attained, therefore, the beatific vision. Who are they? Well, you can go to the Bible and you'll see that Elijah, he was the one that was taken up in a fiery chariot. Traditional Roman Catholic theology says that the Blessed Virgin Mary is a member also. And they cite her life on earth as the reason for her assumption into heaven. Now, we really don't know who they are for sure. We'll just have to wait and see, won't we? Now, that in a nutshell is the communion of saints. And we thank God for the communion of saints this day, All Saints Sunday. And we thank him that God has surrounded us with so great a cloud of witnesses that we are a part of them and they us. And so therefore, we can become what God wants us to be in this life. We can say no to sin and yes to sanctity. We can be that example to other people that we all want to be, because even though the world may see us as inhibited fools, which at times they do, we are God's children, always and forever. All things come of thee, O Lord. Amen. We offer this holy sacrifice to the greater glory of Almighty God in thanksgiving for the passion, death, resurrection, and ascension of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And also this day for the communion of saints, those who have died and gone before us, those who are worshiping God in heaven. And we pray especially for the church militant that they may stand up and proclaim the faith by word and deed throughout their life. Brethren, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
Lord, receive this sacrifice at thy hands. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant that all those who do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, that they may both by their life and doctrine set forth thy true and lively word and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, especially John and Janine and Florence and Robert, Dusty, Alexandria, Bill, Elizabeth, Ernest, Betty, Carl, Emmett, Cecil, Helen, Diane, Charles, Hazel, Franklin and Charlotte, James, Anna, Roy, Catherine, Maureen, Mary, Harold, Douglas, Eugene, Harry, Ellen, Bernice, Ellen and Henry, Sydney and Laura, Frank, Maria, George, Catherine, and Connie. We beseech thee to grant them continual growth, O Lord, in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate. Ye who do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors and intend to lead a new life following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort and make your humble confession unto Almighty God, devoutly kneeling. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. The burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and the glory of thy name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who with great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Hear what comfortable words our Savior Christ saith to all who truly turn to him. Come unto me, all you that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul saith. This is a true saying and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John saith. If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God. It is very meet, right, and our bond and duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, everlasting God, who in the multitude of thy saints has compassed us about with so great a cloud of witnesses, that we, rejoicing in their fellowship, may run with patience the race that is set before us, and together with them may receive the crown of glory that fadeth not away. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, let us pray. All glory be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there by his one oblation of himself once offered a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world. And did institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that, his precious death and sacrifice, until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he brake it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me. Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty, with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us, and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Deliver us, we beseech thee, O Lord, from all evils, past, present, and to come. And at the intercession of all thy saints, grant peace favorably in our day. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, grant us thy peace.
We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table. But thou art the same, Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him that taketh away the sins of the world. Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in the remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in the remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in the remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us who have duly received these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech thee, O heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Depart in peace.
Thanks be to God.
The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge of and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
the beginning of the gospel according to John. Glory be to thee, O Lord. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for a witness to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, and even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor the will of the flesh, nor the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth.
Thanks.